Look at that piece of brush. Should be big crappies on this. That's just me. Should go. Doom. Oh yeah, there's one right there. Big one too, dude. Power pulls down. Look at that. Oh, Lordy, how's that for a start, man? Hey, single pulling some brush. And you sometimes you put it in the best spots and you almost have doubts. He spit out this color right here.
Slab magnet's called the therapist. You know why? It's fantastic therapy
for catching those. Beautiful. I'll bet you that's 13 and a half in the box to start out. Single poling, stocking. Let's put them inside here. All right. Come on, take it easy, little crappie. Go on in there. Let's give him some fresh water. You see what I said, man? If you find that, look at that. Take a look at that real good, real quick. Look at that thing. It's blown up bulrushes, some trees and branches and stuff. And sometimes when nature gives you elements that aren't good, like a flood, and you can't go fishing, the water's mud, they close the areas off and stuff because it's just dangerous. And then you say, come on, what's going to happen? Some stuff gets blown away, your favorite stuff. But then Mother Nature says, hey, Carl, look what's there. New brush. Guess what finds it? That's why I say crappie fishing is so reminiscent of largemouth fishing. They're like wild little dogs. Smallmouth do the wander, chasing bait fish to hang out together. Big largemouth are like stock hunters like me and you, really. They're one-on-one, lone wolves, going looking, pitching all day long, pulling the hat down, glasses on, looking for those big fish. We might catch three or four a day. You say, is that a good day of fishing? You care? I don't even care. I'm after big fish, man. I like to stock big ones. Riverboat gambler, you know, just go out there, put the jig on, plastic, go for it. When it comes to big crappies too, when I pick up that jig pole, I know what I'm looking for. Bigger than average fish. I put on that little slab magnet, and I know if I stick with it, I'm gonna catch. We're just gonna keep going here. I'm gonna drop one right down. I got the power poles down. Let's put it down. Let's see who else is home. But you gotta keep it high. Get their attention. I'm sitting in 6 feet of water. 6 feet of water, dudes. And that's what happens when you find the right spot. And look at that. My goodness, eh? Wow. It's just wow. I ain't got more words for that. All I can say is my heart rate and beat is going nuts. He's another decent one. But what I don't want to do, and I will, I'll show you, I'll let fish go. I'm going to want to put them back and maybe spook the school. Happens with smallmouth all the time. It's all kinds of, you know, anglers put it on websites and stuff all the time. Don't spook the spool. Don't spook the school. Keep fishing. Don't spook them. I'm just going to keep going. But here's what I do too. Make sure that crappie magnet is pushed right up on that little jig head. Bright chartreuse. This one, like I said, is called a therapist. Bright purple. A little bit of blue flake. Chartreuse tail. Look at that. That entices me, man. If I was a crappie, I would eat it. Pick up the Sams, slowly stalk over. Look at me go, man. Hey, one-on-one, ready to drop it in. I drop it in, one shake. Who else wants to come out and play? Hey, come on. Oh my goodness. I watched him come out. Oh, Lordy. Uh-oh. I watched him come out like this. Wah! Remember, I'm in 6 feet of water, man. And that's with the trolling motor down, so it could be about 7 feet. 7 feet with brush, man. Seriously? Wow. gonna keep fishing. I'm gonna keep fishing. This is live, man. Uncut video. Jig mount. Come on. Where's that 16, 17 incher? Come on. Uh-oh. We're going down in size. Did we catch the monster that was there first? I'm a big believer in largemouth. The big one owns the bay. He owns the bay. So when I say you go into a bay, find the big one, move on. Unless you got fantastic cover, obviously. But I do believe, like a big bear, that little one, if you spook the school, I don't care. Because, man, I'm after giants. And I still believe they see that,
they're gonna eat it.
Check my line. Come on. I know there's gotta be big guys in there too. Uh-oh. I know what you're saying. Carl got lucky on those first couple fish, because Carl is now catching them like babies. Did he catch Mama and Papa? And all the little ones are there? Go on, little one. Don't spook the school. Let's just keep rolling, man. Let's keep rolling. How many can we put on this clip? How many? Do I need to move a little bit more along this sunken brush? I can't even see my bait now. It's down. Oh my goodness. There's all babies here. There's all babies. I can't believe it. But here's what I don't want to do. I don't want to rush. I don't want to pick up the poles and start moving around this brush pile or the sunken brush, because there could be a lot of crappie in there. Like, I mean a lot. And once I start moving around, I could put the spook. They always come back. Like, really, who's kidding who? You know, you catch them, they come back to the same spot. You know, I fish with my buddy Chopper and Luke and stuff, and the way they mark brush piles and stuff, go by it, throw a marker boy right on top of the brush pile, and I'm like, oh man, you spooked them. Doesn't matter. They go in a little circle, come back to it, then you know the crappie are there. They see them with the view on their sonar. I'm just gonna keep dropping. We're just gonna keep rolling, man. I'm gonna make my cameraman's arm ready to fall off. But we are gonna just keep catching crappie, hopefully. Some more big ones are here. Oh, I just saw a good one. Just a little pop. He's a little bit better. But again, not like the first ones, dude, huh? Not like the first ones. Maybe. Should I change color? I don't think so. Should I change anything? Uh-uh. It's like catching a 5-pound bass, and then now all you're catching is pound and a half. And you say, wow, what happened? Let's see. Come on. Come on. I'm in the lion's den. A little deeper. I don't even feel it. I got to emphasize something here. Look at my bait. Okay. He pulled it down. The water up here in Northern Ontario, where I'm fishing, is a real dark tea color stain. Stain, man. And once this bait, okay, my hand is at the top of the surface of the water. I'm that low, and I don't see it anymore. How do I know I get bit? See that right there? Right there, the blank through the handle. I got my middle finger, or this finger, right there. There's no way in the world I'm not gonna feel that ding. That's all it is. It's not a violent thing, it's just ding. What they're doing is coming up like this, and going, inhaling. Sometimes they're so aggressive that they blow at it. And you feel the bite. They're like, poof. They use such velocity to try to pull in a bait, very similar to walleye, that sometimes they blow the bait. You think you got a bite, you set, oh, what happened? Put it back in the same spot, because that's crappie. Now I'm gonna give my cameraman a second break so he can put his arms down, get the second breath, and then I'm gonna come back and catch some more fish right here.